Ombudsman Samuel Martirez raised eyebrows earlier this week when he told lawmakers the audit reports of the Commission on Audit on Government Agencies should not be publicized to prevent the public from prejudging those involved. This suggestion has earned the ire of several sectors who say this could fuel corruption. Joining us now for a reaction is the Secretary General of the National Union of Journalists of the Philippines, Len Olea. Len, nice to see you again. Thanks for joining us today and welcome to the program.
Good afternoon, Carmina, and thank you for inviting me.
All right, first off, we're going to talk about what's happening with Maria Ressa and Atom Araulio in a bit as well. But first, let's get into this. The Ombudsman calling on COA not to publicize. On one hand, and I know you've come across items before wherein you follow this lead based on what the COA said, and in the end, it turns out that these items have actually been resolved. But it begins with insinuations, maybe even suspicions, but later on finding that it's been resolved between COA and the agency. They've actually submitted certain documents. So that's one part. But on the other hand, you got to talk about transparency as well. What's going to happen to that if COA does indeed follow the Ombudsman's lead not to publish such findings, Len?
Yes, that's very true. Transparency is very important in government, and journalists and the public in general need to know what's going on with the budget of government agencies. So we really think that Ombudsman Martirez's advice, or what you call advice for COA not to release reports, is kind of problematic because it reduces the transparency in government, and especially now that access to information is somehow limited.
Talking about the realm of possibilities, what do you think falls into that realm of possibilities when the flags, the eventual resolutions, maybe even non-resolutions, are kept between the COA and the agency involved and away from the public eye, Len?
Well, the level of corruption will definitely be higher if we remove the publication of COA reports, especially now during the budget hearing session. It's very important for the public to know what happened to the budget allocation of government agencies. This is the period where we discuss, in the Congress during the budget deliberation, if there are irregularities, whether or not these are eventually resolved or not, it is still the right of the public to know about these matters. Mm.
And it sort of gives us a glimpse into how the leadership functions in a particular agency.
Yes, definitely. In the past, we have seen how the pandemic-related expenses, for example, are not properly disbursed. And of course, with the budget allocated to government agencies, it's important for the public to participate in the discussions by way of looking into the COA report. Besides the taxpayers' money ang involved dito, di ba? Mm-hmm. So, importante talaga na malaman din natin, no? Hindi lang sa pagitan ng COA and the concerned government agencies dapat klaseng makaulat.
And that should take precedence over the feelings of officials that may be involved, because that's what the Ombudsman is pointing to. The prejudging that may take place, the insinuations that may happen or form in the public's minds, he's safeguarding that. But what about safeguarding the public money?
Yes. Kung wala naman talagang kasalanan at walang korupsyon, there should be nothing to fear. And may due process naman ang COA and other government agencies so they can clear their names or the names of the officers and the government agencies, no, eventually. Pero importante that they should be transparent because they owe it to the public to report about the spending of the government.
I'm going to shift now to the topic of two journalists that have figured in the headlines this week. Let's talk about the tale of two journalists, one winning the final tax evasion case lodged against her, the other filing a $2 million damage suit against red taggers, both pushing back while soldiering on. What are your thoughts on this, Lynn?
Of course, NUJP welcomes the filing of civil case by Atom Araulio against the rabid red taggers. We think it's an important move to exact accountability from these malicious red taggers, and we know how red tagging poses serious risks to journalists. On the other hand, of course, we are happy that the last tax evasion case filed against Maria and Rappler has already been dismissed. This is, of course, a positive development.
But make no mistake about it, Len, this is not just about Atom, this is not just about Maria Ressa and Rappler. What does the public need to understand about these cases? That it may be about these two, or three, if you include the Rappler newsroom, but do these also ultimately affect them, and how, Len?
Exactly. Atom said during the press conference that action is a small contribution to the fight for press freedom. Because, as he said, he is privileged enough to be able to file, unlike many of our colleagues in the provinces who do not have the resources and the lawyers to file charges against red taggers and other enemies of press freedom. And we agree to that statement because ultimately it is the public interest that we are protecting here. If journalists cannot do their work, the right of the public to information is jeopardized. So by fighting for press freedom, we also fight for the people's right to know important issues, important matters, like, for example, the budget deliberations that are ongoing now in the House of Representatives and the like.
But here's the thing, Len, even with that damage suit, the two now, if you add Caro Araulio's charges against Badoy and Celis, these charges haven't deterred them, it seems. In a recent appearance, they continue on with their statements, even saying that these suits give the moral inspiration to the followers. They also claim that this is a classic example, in so many words, of the weaponization of the law against the government and the fight against the CPP, NPA, NDF. They even went as far as saying that this filing of charges can also be seen as sort of a recruitment. It's propaganda, according to them. Your thoughts, Len?
Those statements are really laughable. It is the government that has been using all its resources, the entire state machinery, against truth tellers. We were informed by lawyers, for example, that the charges we filed, the administrative complaint we filed against Badoy and Parlade in December 2001, also in relation to red tagging, has been dismissed by the ombudsman. So imagine, we have been trying to exact accountability. What we want is for the red taggers to stop this dangerous practice. And we are only exercising our right to be exhausted, our right to seek redress and to fight for justice. And it's really ironic that these red taggers are now claiming that we have been, it is a weaponization of the law, when in fact they are the ones who have been wantonly violating the rights of journalists to exercise press freedom and free expression. And by extension, they also violate the right of the public to information.
Len Olea there, Secretary General of the National Union of Journalists of the Philippines. Thanks again for joining us this noon. Take care and you keep safe.
Thank you so much, Carmina.